A pimp, a prostitute, and a journalist walk into a bar. Do you know the punchline? No? It's okay because it's not funny anyways. All right, we're going to talk about episode 5 of Interview the Vampire, the second season. Oh yeah, by the way, my name is Leslie. Welcome to my channel, Books, Cause, and Purrs and all that. Today we're going to talk about the top 5 moments in no particular order. We're just gonna dive in. All right, so this episode is set in San Francisco. By the way, love the title card. I'm trying to stay on point. The whole point of the top 5 is just for me to like stay on point. Okay, so we're in San Francisco. Louis almost unalives Daniel after the interview. To young Daniel, and Armand comes into the picture, and part of Louis and Armand really get into it. Like, the actor Assad comes in, and it's just like he's at a 10 the entire episode. It was incredible. Armand is just like so frustrated and tired of Louis and still whining Louis, right? That's what Lestat would say. Still whining about like what happened in the past, his relationship with Lestat, what happened with Claudia. But ultimately he digs in and says, everything that you're saying about Claudia, it's really not about Claudia. It's about the fact that you're still in love with Lestat. It always circles back to Lestat. And oh man, this seems like the kind of argument you would have at the end of a relationship where you're just so fed up with each other. And then like all this ugliness and toxicity comes out, just everything that's bothering them about the relationship just kind of like is out in the open and exposed. So although this is a show about vampires, what Anne Rice does so well is like she's really writing about the human condition. I know you see that about a lot of books, but this is like it's so emotionally heightened, right? And so what they do, which oh my gosh, it's like it's funny, but it's also sad. It's hurtful. Is when Armand like puts on Louis's accent and is like basically saying like, okay, this is a caricature of all that I'm tired of hearing from you. And Louis does the same thing. And it's like, it's so messed up that Louis says, oh, my maker groomed me. And something about that, hearing that is like, what about that is something to make light of. It was just like so frustrating. There's no right person in this argument, right? This whole episode, there's a whole bunch of wrong happening. And oh my goodness, I'm sorry. What also, even before that, you know, like Armand comes in and he's just like frustrated. And what we learn is that he's had to constantly clean up after Louis. So Louis is just like in this, he's in a very bad emotional state. And so what we learn is that Armand has had to come in time and time again and clean up after Louis. And that's, oh, I'm trying not to go all over the place. All I say is that was very, it was very telling. I'll just say that. But even at the start of the argument, like Louis lashes out just like he would do with Lestat. Louis does something that he did to Lestat in last season. Last season, Lestat said something very vulnerable to Louis and that he says like, he doesn't want to be alone, and he's basically getting at the fact that he has like abandonment issues, right? And that they should never part. But when Louis feels like he's like on the verge of being done with Lestat, what does he tell Lestat? He says, you're always going to be alone. And that's before Claudia comes into the picture. And so Louis does that once again. He basically does that, but with Armand. He looks at Armand and he lashes out and he says, you are boring. And it's just so hurtful because he knows that Armand also has vulnerability. He's someone that's constantly putting his mask on, especially in this relationship, because he wants to be the perfect partner. He wants to be whatever Louis wants him to be, instead of like holding on to his like authentic self in a relationship. It's just very code of, it's just should I say Stepford Wives? It's really terrible, because how could Armand ever be truly like at peace with himself when he's performing all the time, right? This is a very unbalanced relationship. And to hear that Armand lashes out and says, oh, you know, about Claudia, going back to them hurling their caricatures of each other at each other. When he speaks of Claudia, he says, sister, daughter, throw pillow. She didn't love you. Like, I love you, Lestat, love you, but she didn't. And it was just like so. I feel like Claudia did love her vampire parents, but she was also just so tired, so done, and probably pissed, and had a lot of resentment. But I think that's like what tips Louis over the edge. I'm trying to think about when I should talk about this. Well, that will we'll just leave that there. So that their argument was just, it was epic. And we kind of just see the toxic side. And once again, we see how Louis kind of like uses that the vulnerability tactic to like just I don't know, like really hurt Armand. It was just like, it was so messed up. All right, getting to the second top five moment. Barbecue Louis. Oh my goodness. Where do I say this? Louis went ahead and roasted in the sun. Oh, that was a hard scene to see, but I was expecting it. I wasn't expecting this scene to come so soon. I thought, because I, you know, because I read the books, this moment in the book happens like 7 or 8 books in. And I don't know if I should go into that yet. Let me put this a pin in this really quick. So he steps out into the sun. He hears the ghost of Claudia. We assume he just he says he Louis says that he hears her, and that he goes to step into the sun. And I thought in this moment that a character was going to appear from oh, what's that show called? The Mayfair Witches. I had to look it up. I thought the character Cyprian was going to show up. I was so wrong about that. I like guessed that before the show came out. I was trying to figure out how they were going to adapt Louis trying to unalive himself. So in the Book of Merrick, Louis gets involved with like a witch per se, and I think they, I try to remember what happens, but he like seeks her out, something like that. And so he's trying to contact the ghost of Claudia. Other people have actually come in co the contact with the ghost of Claudia. So the fact that like Louis finds this out, his need to get a hold of her, possibly like for closure, is just like at an all-time high. So in the Book of Merrick, this witch helps him out, but the witch makes it very clear that just because you see, like if she performs this like spell or whatever she does, there's no guarantee that this is actually Claudia. It could also be bringing something else from the spirit world. And so what happens is the ghost of Claudia comes, and she says actually what Armand says in the show, which is that like, you know, I hate you. Like she just takes out all her anger out and Louis, and says what, you know, what we think is what she really feels, and that pushes Louis over the edge. And that could be a couple of things. Is it was it really Claudia? Was it some sort of spirit coming through? Or did this spirit really just project all of Louis' fears and then attack him with that? Do you know what I mean? It's kind of up in the air. But either way, that pushes Louis over the edge and he tries to unalive himself. Now, in the book, that's when Lestat appears to save Louis. So they're getting that moment and they're like adapting it for season two. I think this is a great idea because ultimately that moment happens books later, and we need this moment to happen earlier. We need to have Louis' story arc, excuse me, get to a place of like closure. And they want to, like, I guess you could say, like, finish out Interview the Vampire, which is really like the origins of Louis, right? It's really the vampire Louis story. And so, not that I condone someone unaliving themselves, but I think that that moment, Louis had to go through it to get to a point to choose life. Like, this is a moment where he was in so much pain, he chose death to get on like the other side of it. And I'll get back to that later, but I really just wanted to like hit a conversation about Merrick. All right, moving along to number three, the coffin scene. I'm gonna try to just I want to talk about every little thing, so let me just get to it. Armand puts Louis in a coffin, and Armand is basically saying like, I'm done. I'm always basically I feel like he's saying, I'm always cleaning up after you. This is the cycle. I'm done. Like, this is the point where I think Armand and Louis are gonna go on a break. Okay. And so he says as like a last parting gesture, he's gonna contact Lestat. But before I get to that, I will say that Armand really is continuing to let Armand is continuing to let Louis have it, but like in a softer way versus the argument they just had. And Armand points something out. He answers a question that I have been hypothesizing, theorizing with all my tinfoil hat ideas about why Louis wants this interview. And you know what? Man, oh man, do I love these writers and the creators, because the answer is right in front of us. It's very simple, but it's also the embodiment of Anne Rice's work, right? Which is just heightened emotions, yearning, love. It's all those things. And Armand points out that he's under the impression that the real reason why Louis wants this interview is because he wants to make contact with Lestat, but he wants Lestat to come to him. And that blew my mind. It took me, I've already seen this episode three times, and it hit me so hard. And after the third time, something really hit me. And I will say this about that. That in season one, we have to think about what both these characters love. Lestat loves music, right? He loves opera. He even loves composing. He wrote a song for his first great love, Nikki. And then he wrote another song for his second great love, which is Louis. And in the second song to Louis, he crafts this song, and he writes it in a way that Louis will respond, because he knows Louis so well. Louis is a person that pulled a knife out on his own brother. And even Louis' relationship with his sister, they're very kind of like, oh, what's the word? Not catty. The way that they show love is kind of like picking at each other. And so that's just the way that Louis shows his love. He's not going to say, I love you. If Louis says he loves you outright, probably doesn't love you. I'm going all over the place. What happens is that Lestat writes a song in a way that it will bother him so that Louis will chase after him. And so that's it. I think that's what it is, that now we look at what Louis loves. Louis loves to read. He loves sitting at a park bench with Lestat and reading newspapers and philosophizing. He loves reading when he is recuperating. He loves to read when he was absolutely miserable while Claudia was missing. What do we see him doing in Dubai? He's reading Hate and Ashbery, right? Yeah, Hate and Ashbery by Daniel Malloy. He loves reading. So when he's in San Francisco in the 70s, conducting this interview, what is he doing? He's crafting the almost perfect, love letter to Lestat in the only in the way that he knows how, through literature, because that's what he loves. And what is going to be the thing that's off, right? The thing that is off is that he's going to say it with a with hateful words, and that would piss off Lestat. And then Lestat, what would he do? He would come to him, right? And much like when Lestat wrote a song, he what did he do? He added his lover to the song because he's like, oh, that's gonna grind his biscuits, and he's gonna be over here. Oh my God, I was like, it came to me like after the third watch. I was so just absolutely mesmerized and in awe of this moment that was the answer was right in front of us. I was so like obsessed. But also going back to the way that Armand says this, I bust out the vampire Lestat, which I always have handy. And so even the way that he tells Louis, how he like, oh, Lestat's gonna see the book through the window of a bookstore, and then he's gonna read it, and then he's gonna come chasing after you. I'm gonna read you a little bit from the book. All right, so Lestat has a book, and he says, I stood stock still beneath a street lamp with a book until I finished it. Then I placed it carefully over in my breast pocket, which by the way, that also reminded me when Dreamstat was at the bench and he said, I had your initials put into the breast pocket. And then Lestat goes on to say, and when the night was empty and still, I heard the voices of Interview with the Vampire singing to me as if they sang from the grave. I read the book over and over, and then in a moment of contemptible anger, I shred it to bits. Then Lestat goes on to say, I had to find Louis. I had to talk to him. In fact, after reading his account of things, I ached for him, ached for his romantic illusions and even his dishonesty. I ached even for his gentlemanly malice and his physical presence, the deceptively soft sound of his voice. Ugh, it still gets me. So I had to bust that out to read that to you, because as soon as I heard Armand talking, as soon as I heard the dialogue, I thought, holy ish, they're grabbing it from the book. It looks so good. All right, sticking with the coffin scene, Armand contacts Lestat. So this is at the point where like Armand's like, I almost feel like Armand's calling his bluff. I don't think that was really what he was doing. I think he's just like so over what they've gone through, and he's so tired of like Louis whining about like the true love of his life. But also I feel like this is a way that Louis needs to figure out what he wants. Like I really think that after this they're gonna go on a break, and it's gonna be because Armand's like, we can't keep going like this, and you legitimately need to figure out what you want. But ultimately that scene where Armand contacts Lestat, I think it was just Armand bit off more than he could chew, really, because then he had to hear from Lestat how Lestat still, after all this time, loves Louis, and he and Armand knows Louis still loves Lestat. And it's just another moment, like, there's so many times in Armand's life where he's never the one that people choose, if that makes any sense. Even in Louis choosing him, that was well orchestrated, which we're going to see in the next episode. But time and time again, Louis has, like, from the very beginning, not really been that interested in Armand. It's always been Armand pursuing Louis. And with that said, Armand hears Lestat say, "Tell him I love him." And there's so much that's going on that moment. At first, I felt bad for Armand because he's having to hear this. But then I realized, ultimately, when Armand hears this, it's like twofold. Like, it's painful. I get that. But also, what did Armand do to Nikki? He took Nikki away from Lestat. And in this moment, he's also taking Louis away from Lestat. And I think that this isn't just about Armand being in love with Louis. It's about how petty and how he has kept his own grudges as well against Lestat, that he also feels like a lover scorned, even though, like, it was definitely not reciprocated by Lestat, right? It was all, like, a performance. But also because Armand did all this crazy crap. Anyways, getting to the point, I feel like this is the pattern. Like, can you imagine being Lestat and knowing that Armand took Nikki away from him and now he's blocking Lestat from contacting Louis in a way? So that makes me look at, like, the fact that they're together, or that they're in Dubai, in a whole new light, because it's also Armand is protecting Louis. He's trying to keep him from unaliving himself. But also it's because he's really just trying to keep him away from Lestat. It's so complicated. It's all the things, it's all the reasons. So yeah, it's complicated, which then leads me to number four, rest. Armand tells young Daniel to rest. And so it's his intention to take Daniel's life. But I feel like Armand, in talking to Daniel, he's doing what he does time and time again. He underestimates a person's potential, whether it's human or not, before they even have a chance to, like, to try at making, like, you know, as we go through life, we kind of, like, have to try to get past, like, you know, life's hurdles. And he's already saying, like, "Oh, I already know who you are, Daniel. You're just gonna create a cycle, like your parents. You're gonna be your parents. You're not gonna go anywhere." And I feel like, once again, he's underestimating like who Daniel could be, the same way that he underestimated Claudia's grit and drive to thrive in a vampiric life. The way that he underestimates Santiago and what he's capable of, just the way that he underestimated Lestat, because Lestat and Santiago both, like, got the coven to turn against him, right? And that happens time and time again. And if he just didn't underestimate people, he would be in the problems that he creates in like the first place. And so my issue with Armand is that he's continuously conflating experience with wisdom. And just because he has all these years that he's lived does not mean that he has wisdom. So Louis intercedes and tells him that, you know, like, Danielle being alive is kind of like, I think, a symbol of their relationship flourishing. Like, let's do this to make amends, do this thing for me, and keep Danielle alive. And I love this because this leads to Daniel in modern day, current times Dubai, realizing that, like, on page 484 of Hayton Ashbury, something that he wrote in there that didn't quite make sense is actually something that Louis said. And so this is how I took it. Let me ask you something. Let me know if you agree. So Daniel believed in himself before Louis said anything. He believed that, like, no, I want to live. I'm good at this. I'm good at talking to people. I'm good at finding an angle, and I'm going to be a journalist. And so Louis creates it like a mantra for him after, and says, like, no matter what happens in life, basically just, like, be a journalist. He basically saying that he has a reason to live. He has a purpose. And when Daniel says that this mantra helped him kind of like go through life and kept pushing him along, I thought that was like a beautiful scene. And I didn't take that moment as like Daniel's passion for his craft being manufactured. I didn't take it that way. I think, like, this is something that he really wanted to do. I think it was just that he didn't know that Louis was actually his lifeline, right? Because this was someone that before they met has addiction issues and continue to have addiction issues. And imagine if he didn't have that moment with Louis, he might not have lived past his 20s, or at least that's how I see it. And I also want to focus on this because what Daniel realizes is that in the book, he pictures somebody else telling him this, like another junkie that, like, set himself on fire. But it wasn't, it was actually Louis. So is this more confirmation that what the fans think is true, that Alice in his mind is not really Alice, that Alice is actually Armand? I'm hoping that's not true, okay? It's not, or that Alice is true, but, like, I'm hoping that Alice actually exists, but that, like, Daniel's experiences with Armand are mixed up with Alice. That's what I'm hoping has happened, but let me know, because we're inching closer and closer to, I think, that being true. And I'm shocked because that's not a theory that I came up with. That's, like, something that the fans have been thinking for a while. Oh, give me a second. My battery is about to run out. All right, where was I? Number five, moving along. Louis and Armand unionize. Just like when Lestat turned the coven against Armand, just like when Santiago turns the coven against Armand, Armand shows up and they're both looking at Armand and they are not happy. And if there's anything that I learned from the show and also reading the books, is that when people are, like, in what do you call it, like a relationship where three people are involved, it does not go well. Someone's gonna get pushed out. And so, oh, actually, with exception of Louis Lestat and David Talbot, actually, let me go there. Let me go there. From the very beginning, I thought that Daniel was going to be a composite of David Talbot. And then in the books, we kind of know later on that they're all living together, right? Even all the way in, like, Merrick. So I'm going to go there. I can't help myself. By the end, I feel so confused. Do you think that Armand is going to make Daniel a vampire, or do you think Louis is? Or is he going to just, is he going to die? Anyways, this ultimately just leads me to more questions. Do you think, not consciously, But do you think, like, on some level, are the okay? So here's the deal. I think we know now why Louis wants this Dubai interview to happen. But what about Armand? We understand that he didn't agree, but he still let it happen. Do you think that when Armand has said in the past, like, oh, I let Lestat break apart the coven, or the fact that we kind of see how Armand is orchestrating letting the coven, the theater coven, fall apart. Do you think this is also another indication of something that Armand is letting happen? Do you think him and Louis are just so done with each other, but he can't bring himself to end it, that these two passive aggressive people are coming, their relationship's coming into an end this way, that maybe knowing that Daniel is getting older, that although Armand would never turn anyone, maybe this is it. Maybe their relationship ending is Armand wanting a companion, wanting Daniel, because ultimately Armand is similar to Louis in that way. They just can't directly end their relationship, is what I'm saying. They're too like codependent, too much chaos, too much toxicity. Oh, my other question, which is back about San Francisco, before I forget. I keep thinking about what was going on with Louis, in relation to what happened to Lestat and when Lestat was made. When Lestat was made, his maker threw himself into the fire, and there were all these other bodies that looked similar to him, right? And so I was thinking about Daniel in San Francisco. Do you think that Louis would have made him a vampire? I'm just thinking that like those situations kind of like are similar, that Louis was going mad. He was systematically unaliving people. And what if that pattern continued? What if he decided, I'm done with life. I'm gonna make Daniel, like this is the one. I'm gonna make him a vampire and then walk into the sun. I don't know. That just kind of popped in my head. Do you think that he would have made him a vampire, basically? But going from there, just to wrap it up, there was a behind the scenes photo, and we do see a glimpse of the interview vampire, Interview with the Vampire, the book, on a table. So we do know it gets published. So that's why I think episode 7 is going to be the vampire Lestat. And it's going to be him. I don't know. Is he going to see the book? Is that going to kind of play out? I don't know. I was just so excited to see that we know for a fact that the book gets published. But then if the book gets published, what does that mean for Daniel? I don't know. I keep saying I don't know. My mind is just swimming. Get ready for next week. Oh, what else did I want to say? I guess I just wanted to add that I'm glad that this particular episode came when it did, because I guess for the people that haven't read the books, they're seeing that whatever happened in Paris has such a large ripple effect that in the, how do I say, in the 1970s, Armand still feels like he's never going to be able to atone for his sins. Anyways, this episode was incredible. Next week's episode is going to be incredible. That's going to crush me. That one's going to crush me. I will be stepping out into the sun after next week's episode. All right, let me know what you think. All of you book readers and TV watchers, let's go into it. Let's talk all the theories. And if anybody could chime in about that Alice's Armand thing, I have a lot of questions, but we'll see how it plays out. All right, so if you're a new subscriber, thank you for listening to my all over the place crazy rants. And if you're returning, thank you so much. I've enjoyed this season so much just because of you. On top of everything, every episode is an absolute delight. Yeah, so yeah, like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the chat.